Hi friends, I am Tufan. Welcome to CMI's digital classes. Today we will learn the first chapter, that is revision of chapter class 4, question number 36 and 37 and further. So whatever the question number 36 is, a car consumes 1 liter of petrol to cover a distance of 20 km. That means in 1 liter of petrol, it is covering a distance of 20 km. So in 2 liter of petrol, how much kilometer it will move? Very good, 40 kilometer. In 3, 60 kilometer. 4, 80 kilometer. So whatever the distance that multiply by 20, right? Because 1 liter, 20 kilometer. 2 liter, 40 kilometer. 3 liter, 60 kilometer. So whatever the kilometer that multiply by this, right? So here it is asking, if it consumes 8 liter of petrol, that means in 8 liter, as like I said, in 1 liter 20, 2 liter 40, so in 8 liter how much it will cover? Definitely we will do the multiplication here. So let's solve this. So in 1 liter of petrol, it covers a distance of 20 km. You have to write the language, so I am not writing the language so much. Okay, therefore, in 8 liter of petrol, it moves. So I am writing that much only. So in 8 liters of petrol, understood the concept? That is enough. So in 8 liter of petrol, it will cover, in 8 liter of petrol, it will cover is equal to 20 multiply 8. That means 2 8 are 16 and 0, so 160 kilometer. Don't forget to write the unit. So 160 kilometer total it will move in 8 liters of petrol. In case of 10 liter of petrol, 10 multiply 20. Okay, so 200. So like this, you can find out as much as liters of petrol it will give. Now next type of problem which we have is, a bag contains this much of rupees. In a bag, 21 rupees and 50 paise, that means 21.50 rupees are there. So what is the cost of such 8 bags? So the same thing here, the cost of one bag is given, you have to find the cost of 8 bags. So if I am saying the cost of one bag is 10 rupees, what will be the cost of 2 bags? Then 10 multiplied to 20 rupees, right? If I am saying the cost of one bag is 30 rupees, what will be the cost of 4 bags? So 30 multiplied 4. Right. So here also, if the cost of one bag is that much, so we will find by multiplying for 8 bags. But here the multiplication at decimal is there, we will do as much as normal multiplication only. But after the result, whatever the result will come, we will give the decimal before 2 digits. So okay. So here let's do either even do direct multiplication also, or even do the multiplication by process also. What is the cost? So solution, the cost of 8 bags is equal to rupees 21.50 multiply it. So just multiply this and send the result. Okay. Here I am writing as this case is not even down. So here the multiplication result will be 800, 5 meter 14, so 0, 4 carry, so 4 carry, 8 1 are 8 plus 4, 12, so 2, 1 carry, 8 to the 16, 16 plus 1, 17, okay. So before 2 digit you have to give decimal, that means before 2 0, so rupees 170. 2 will be the answer. Okay, you can check the multiplication here. 2 1 decimal 50
multiplying by 8. So 800 is 40. Okay. So 4, 12, 2, 1 carry, 17. So before 2 digit decimal, show 172. So that is how the rupees 172 will be the price of 8 bags. This is how you can solve the word problems of question number 36 and 37. A factory produces 480 bulbs. So there is a factory which is producing 480 bulbs in 8 days. So here it is given for 8 days, not for 1 day. Try to understand. So that means when it is given for many days or many things and you want to find for one, then you have to divide first. So suppose I am telling the cost of 10 chocolates is 80 rupees. The cost of 10 chocolate is 80 rupees. Okay. The cost of 10 chocolate is 80 rupees. And I am saying what will be the cost of 4 chocolates. So to solve this question, first you have to find out the cost of 1 chocolate. So to find out the cost of 1 chocolate, we have to divide this by 10. So 8, 10 are 80. So that means the cost of 1 chocolate is 80 rupees. So when you find the cost of 1 chocolate, then you can find the cost of 4 chocolate also. So 4 multiply 8, so 32 rupees. So this is how, here also first you have to divide, then you have to multiply. So let's do that one. So here first the cost for effect producing this much of bulbs in 8 days. So in 8 days it produced 480 bulbs. So first we have to find out in one day it will produce 480 divided by 8. So in 8 days this much. So when you divide by 8, then you will find for 1 day. So let's divide this. You can do division here also in rough, or you can directly do also. I'm not doing directly because you may not understand if I do directly. So 8 divided by 480. So to read the table of 8, 6 8 are 48. So 6 8 are 48 and 0 1 0. So 60 times. So that means 1 day it is producing this much of bulb, 60 bulb. So we have to find out production for 10 days. So again, it is given for 1 day, therefore we have to find for 10 days. So in 10 days, it will produce is equal to 60 multiply 10, so 600 bulbs. So this is how this type of word problems you have to solve, you can solve. First thing you need to remember, when the price of many or many things is given and you want to find for one, you have to divide. When the price of for one is given, you want to find for many, then you have to multiply. This process is called unitary method. We will learn further in class 4 chapter. We have unitary method chapter. So in that chapter, we will learn more problems like this. This is the revision. So what you have been learning previous class, we are revising. So we will learn few more about. The next type of questions, which is the last questions which we have in chapter number 0, is question number 39. In an examination, Mohan got 89 marks in math, 86 marks in science, 69 marks in social science, 71 marks in Hindi, and 64 marks in English. So that means this question is asking about the marks which a particular student has got in several subjects. So according to that, the questions are asking. Question number first is asking Mohan got a total of. That means how much total marks he is getting. So to find out the total number of marks, total number of anything, we have to add. So we will add all the marks, 64, 71, 69, 86 and
89 and we'll sag, then you will find the total number marks. So let's sag here only directly we are checking. You can do first note it down in a serial number and then you can find out. So here I am doing directly 6, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 9, 14, 14 plus 6, 20, 20 plus 9, 29. So 29 is 9 you will write here and 2 is carry. So 2 is carry, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 7, 15, 15, 15 plus 6, 21, 20 plus, 21 plus 8, 21 plus 8, 29, 29 plus 8, 37. So here 37, 379. Let's check one by rough work also, otherwise it may be wrong. So 89, here we are writing. Let's check here only, don't have space there. So first is 89, second is 86, third is 71, then 86, 89, 71, 69, then we have 64. So how many totals are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. So let's say 9 plus 4, 13, 14, 20, 29, 9, 2 carry, 8 to 10, 18, 18 plus 7, 18 plus 7, 25, 25 plus 6, 25 plus 6, 31, 31 plus 6, 37, 37, yes, correct, 379. So this is how you can find the total number of marks which he got. Okay, now he got the maximum mark. So maximum means the highest number and minimum means the lowest number. So here maximum marks which we have 89, 86, 69, 71, 64. So out of these all check which one is the highest one. Yes, 89. Is there any number more than 89? No. So 89 marks in maths. That means here he got the maximum marks 89 in which subject? Maths. Now he got the least means minimum. Okay, so least mark means minimum marks in which subject? So check minimum marks is in which subject? 69. Is there 64? Yes. So least marks is there in 64 in English. So least marks will be 64 and subjects will be English. So this is how you can find out least or maximum, and then we have his total number of marks in maths and social science. So we have to check in maths how many marks he got? 89. And in social science how much marks he got? 69. So 89 plus 69, 9 plus 18. So 18 is 8. 1 carry. Okay, 8 plus 1 is 9, 9 plus 6 is 15. So 158. You can check it by adding. So 158 is the total number of marks in maths and science, social science. One more question is there, question number 5, which I have not got the space to write. So that is asking about the total number of marks in three particular subjects. So whatever the subject it is asking about, write down the marks of those particular subject and add that, you will find the total number of marks on those all particular subjects. If you see any doubts in chapter number 0, please ask, we will try to explain. If you need any separate video on that particular topic, you can ask, we will try to prepare that also. Okay, don't hesitate to ask questions. So now as a homework, do chapter 0's question number 36 to 39. Okay, thank you, have a good time, take care.